So we'll get started now. Good morning, everyone. I'm Victoria. I'm the recruiter for the undergraduate programs of the DeGroote School of Business. And I want to thank all of you for coming to our area focused webinar on marketing at the DeGroote School of Business. So before we jump into the presentation, just want to go over quickly what an area of focus is. So some of you might be from first and second year, and hopefully you know what our area of focus and program structure is now. But if some of you are applicants and you're here today, I want to just explain what that means. So your first 2 years at DeGroote are general. You take courses from all of our areas. And then in your third and fourth year, you're able to choose an area of focus. So today's area of focus webinar is on marketing. So you can find out more about marketing and find out if this is the right area for you. So before we get started, I just want to introduce our faculty and students. So starting off our presentation today is Dr. Sourav Ray, professor in marketing. His expertise and research interests include industrial and business-to-business marketing strategy with specific interests in high-tech products, distribution, and pricing. Sourav has almost 20 years of experience teaching marketing at all levels, from undergraduate to MBA, and to more specialized master's and PhD programs. And then we'd like to welcome Dr. Chris Ling. Dr. Ling is an expert in consumer behavior and most recently worked as a management consultant in Toronto. As a management consultant, he has helped companies with a variety of management and marketing problems, such as optimizing their branding, redesigning menus, creating solutions to help with new customer acquisition, and determining marketing strategy. And then after the formal presentation, we have two of our current students here. Our students are Leila, who's a third year student at McMaster, and her focus is marketing, and she's one of the incoming co-presidents for the DeGroote Marketing Association. And Naushin, who's also studying commerce with a focus in marketing, and she's our other incoming co-president for next year. So they're going to give you more information on how to get involved as a current student in the DeGroote Marketing Association. Before I pass it over, if you have any questions throughout the webinar, just use the Q&A along the bottom, and then we're going to have time to answer those questions later on. So I'm going to pass it over to you, Sourav.
Thank you, Victoria, and welcome, everyone. It's wonderful to see my fellow panelists over here. So I'm just going to take this opportunity to talk about marketing, at least the way I understand it, and try to give you a sense of what marketing does, and you know, your choices in the school as you go over to choosing different courses in marketing and other areas. So let me start with this. Let me share my screen so that I can screen one, share. Okay, just give me a moment here. Yeah, okay. All right. So let me, so talking about marketing. Okay, so the first question that comes is, what is marketing really? So, and as we see what is marketing, as we go to that point, so there are many different ways marketing is talked about, you know, or defined or made sense of. So one way marketing is defined is it's an organizational function. That's not a surprise. It is a function in an organization and a set of processes that gets a bit confusing. What we mean by sets of processes is essentially the work that goes on in an organization. But the most important is it's for creating, communicating, and delivering value to customers. There are two words that will jump out over there. I have sort of bolded them, I've highlighted them. One is value, another is customers. And you will see this theme sort of runs through everything that we, whenever we talk about marketing, value and customers. There are other ways you can think of marketing, and one very powerful way of thinking of marketing is it's a way of looking at the whole business from the customer's perspective. So what does that really mean? That means if you think about it, businesses exist to serve certain customers. Now, if you want to make sense of your business, how do you make sense of your business from the customer's perspective? And once you are able to do that, you are able to understand much more about how you compete, how customers make choices, and ultimately how you as a business make revenue. Because do not forget, marketing is the key revenue generating function of a firm. So for the time being, I think that should be enough. to sort of get a sense of what marketing should be there. Three things that we have talked about. One is value, one is customers, and one is revenue. Now we have to put these things together as we go through our own journey. So now here is a very busy slide. Okay, so let me sort of deconstruct this thing. You know, so what do marketers do? So we talked about marketing, value, customers, revenue. But what do marketers do? Marketers do a lot of things, as you can imagine, and you may have your own understanding of what marketers do. So here is a little quote that I really like, which sort of captures a lot of what marketers do. And you may be familiar with these Dilbert cartoons by Scott Adams. He says, in one of his cartoons, it was said that I say we should listen to customers and give them what they want. And believe it or not, that captures a lot of marketing. But that's pretty simple, or is it? It does seem simple, but if you think about it a bit deeply, what does listening to customers mean? Listening to customers means, first of all, you need to understand who your customers are. You really need to understand who your customers are. And when you say listening to them, how do you listen to them? You need to not only understand them, but you need to have techniques, you need to have processes, you need to have methods by which you can listen to them carefully and accurately. And there are many, if you think about a market is of course populated by many different segments. Which of those different customer segments are going to be your customers? Not everybody can be your customers. And then what do they care about? That's listening. So if you just step back and think about it, that itself is a fairly complex task that needs, and that's what marketing sort of focuses on. But then there is this whole matter of strategy as well. You give them what they want. Well, mind you, it's not as easy as giving them what they want for two reasons. One, even if you know what the customers want, you may have competition who can give it to the customers better than you can. And there we have this concept of let's delight the customers. If the competitor does a better job of giving customers what they want, then you have no business. And then this whole other thing is customers always want things for free. Well, can you give customers what they want and still make a profit? So there's a whole lot of complexity around the simple notions of marketing. And I don't want to get into all of those, but I want you to think about the marketing's role or what is captured in those, in that box to the left, that marketing discovers sources of value creatively. It's supposed to create value successfully. How does marketers create value? Through what we call the four P's. That's what marketers put together to create value. They have to communicate that value effectively. This is something we all understand, right? You know, marketers do advertisements, promotions. They communicate that value, but then have to capture that value efficiently. That means you set a price. And then sustain that effort over time. And that's very important. You have to think forward. You have to think about competitive reactions. You have to think about competition down the line. So it's a very strategic approach to business. So at the end, of course, why do customers do this? And why do marketers do this? They give customers what they expect and even more, and they still want to be profitable. Second, marketers try to manage customer relationship in ways that benefit the organization and stakeholders. Now, this is a very quick snapshot of what marketers do. Now, I want you to take away one thing about this, that this is true whether you are dealing with consumer markets, B2C. This is true whether you are dealing with business industrial markets in B2B. This is true for low-tech products as well as high-tech products. This is true for retail sector, like fast moving consumer goods, as well as consumer durables, this way of thinking about marketing. So in one way to think about marketing is also the skills or what marketers do and the things that you will learn in our program. It's going to be transferable across multiple contexts. Keep that in mind. Then of course, you know, you can say, let's quickly take a historical view of marketing and see how it has evolved over the years. In marketing, we talk, you know, evolution, we can think of it in many ways, but in marketing, when we try to make sense of how marketing has evolved, we start first thinking about what we call a production orientation, when the focus was just building on a better mousetrap, so to speak, just make a better product and it will sell. Well, soon the focus then changed to sales. Well, you know, let's just sell what we have, the hard sales push, and that was seen as kind of the key function of marketing. But then marketing became a bit more customer focused, customer oriented, the age of marketing concept, where the customer was put at the center of the firm, at the center of the organization. And it evolved further into thinking about relationship marketing, where, you know, all these your loyalty programs, or even companies collaborating with each other. You may have seen Intel Inside logo on computers. These are companies co-branding their products. Then, of course, we come to the new age, the social, the age of social marketing, interactive marketing, the social media. Where social media brought people together to exchange. And then we are shifting over to another new age, which is data-driven predictive user profiling as part of marketing, where the idea is that marketing is a very dynamic field. It's very forward-looking. Marketing, yes, marketing is driven by technology, of course. But marketing also drives change. And nowhere is this example better than when we look at this current age, this evolving age, data-driven user profiling. Marketing is driving those technology changes. So marketing is at the forefront of how our society is making sense of our interactions with businesses. And then, so if you think, you know, what do marketers do? Let me talk about one quick, this is my favorite, you know, one of these quotes by Oscar Wilde, or allegedly attributed to Oscar Wilde. What is a cynic? A man who knows the price of everything and the value of nothing. Remember, I talked about value at the outset. So what does this mean? So what can become the marketer's task? Well, find out the customers who are not cynics. Maybe they become your natural target markets. And if there are cynics, well, what can you as a marketer do to make them see the value of your product or service? So marketers put in a lot of effort to find out which are your target markets, which are your proper target segments. These are likely to be less cynical about your product or service. They're likely to see more value in your product or service. And on the other hand, if there are people who don't see value, if there are segments who don't see value, then marketers can work towards communicating the value and then capturing it from them. So if you think about it that way, marketing is really everywhere. Whether you think of Walmart, Tim Hortons, RBC, Apple, Boeing, Amazon, universities, nonprofits, marketing is everywhere, because everywhere there is some sort of transaction. Some organization is trying to convey some value to their target customers. So who are the customers? Marketers I keep saying marketers need to understand who the customers are. And then, of course, what is the promise that you are giving to your customers, that you are offering? Is the customer willing to pay for it? A big question. And how much? Can the competitors do a better job? And in the end, can you still make a profit? And I put a couple of pictures over there to show that, you know, marketing is as true and as important for a company like General Electric selling turbines, as well as companies selling water or even air. So if you think about that, then let's move to what you will be learning in our classes. And I'm going to keep it broad. Learning deliverables in our marketing courses. You will certainly learn how to conduct research and how to analyze business situations using modern state-of-the-art techniques. You will be pushed and you will learn how to use your creativity in solving problems. So creative and inspired thinking. You will put in a lot of effort in combining your analysis with your creative thinking and designing winning marketing strategies. That's definitely part of what we do in our classes. You will have practice in making important strategic decisions under ambiguity. And then, of course, you will be developing soft skills that will be very useful for business leadership. So now, how do we run our classes, right? So how do we run our classes? What sort of experience? And you will, as we go forward, we have wonderful students with us, Leila and Naushin, and they will talk more about these experiences. We'll hear from them. But from my perspective, what we want to do in our classes is to give you a holistic experiential approach. So our approach is a very experiential approach to your learning. We focus on creating an exciting immersive experience. Some characterize this almost like a mini co-op experience. Why is that? Well, we bring in real cases. We discuss real cases in the classroom. We work with companies in our projects. So you gain some industry experience as well. We hear from industry leaders, practitioners, as well as domain experts. And then, of course, very much part of all this experience will be a lot of activities, extracurricular activities. You'll hear more from, but I've just put in some over here, activities like Mars, Canada's Next Top Ad Exec, Canadian Marketing League, et cetera, et cetera. Now, one of the most important things I want to emphasize out here that in your experience with our classes, you will find we strive to give you this balance between what we call the science and art. You know, there is this very quantitative approach to a very qualitative approach, the objective and subjective, your analysis and creativity. So that's the nature of marketing. So you want to get that hard experience of analysis, but also we want you to use your creativity to complement that analysis and design your winning strategies. So training and confidence to operate in significant cross-functional roles. So as you can imagine, as you take this bigger approach, you develop these experiences going forward. Now, there are two ways you can think about the different marketing courses. The first, so you take the core 1MA3 and 3MC3. These are the core marketing courses everybody will have to take. But then you have these, you know, what I call the substantive marketing courses, sort of the building blocks beyond what you learn in 1MA3 and 3MC3. There's the marketing research, consumer behavior, and business marketing. I'm talking about the electives. These are the three sort of, you know, substantive courses. And then you go on the electives, more specialized marketing research, innovation, sales, retailing, e-marketing, marketing analytics. So these are the courses. If you have questions, we'll try and answer these. Now, of course, what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to hand it over to Dr. Chris Ling. Now, Chris, you have spent time in the industry as a professional marketer, and I know you how excited you get when you remember those times. So you and I know marketing careers can be rewarding, but I am not sure most people have a good idea of what these careers really entail. Especially, and I talked about how marketing has this yin and yang, you know, the analysis and creativity going. So can you talk to us more about what type of jobs our graduates can look for when they are in the market?
Thank you. Thanks, Dr. Ray, for that question. That's a really great question. And so hopefully you can all see my screen. And I think one of the strengths of marketing is the variety of different roles that we have in this discipline. So whether you are a creative person or an analytical person, there are likely roles that would apply and appeal to you. So what I have on the slide up here are three of the most common types of pathways for students. So after graduating from the Commerce Program, you might be thinking, what are some of the things that I could potentially do in marketing? And so the very first thing that you might want to think about is what we call brand or product management. And so here you have the product or service that the company is offering, and you will be in charge, or you'll be helping out with the management of that product and service on a day-to-day basis and really providing value to the consumer in that way. Now, the second bucket that we have is really can think about it as having domain expertise. So whether that's in advertising or PR, communications, media or branding or some other type of marketing expertise, you are the de facto experts in a certain area, and you help companies communicate with their consumers. And that's also a very important function that a lot of jobs are in. And then the final bucket we have is this market or consumer research and insights. And here you're going to develop a deep understanding of the consumer, and then you're going to use that really deep understanding to help inform business strategy and marketing strategy. And if we look at these three different types, we might note that brand and product management, this tends to be more within the firm. So you'll be working for a variety of companies and helping them with their marketing. For advertising, PR, communications, and media, the second bucket, for this one, you might work for an agency or a firm, and you might help multiple clients. So for example, I might work for an agency and I might help Coca-Cola, I might help Pepsi, I might help Procter & Gamble, and so on and so on. And then the final bucket, this market and consumer research and insights, this one we see a mix of both. So you might be working for a firm, for a company in-house, helping them with developing insights, or you might be working for an agency and helping multiple clients. So there is a bit of difference there. Now, one thing I did want to point out about this list is that this is not an exhaustive list, but rather it provides a nice conceptual way to think about some of the most common jobs in marketing. And what's not represented on this list are a number of really great roles that are perhaps a bit more technical or that deals a bit more with business to business. So for example, there are a lot of business to business roles that are involved with what's called technical selling. So if you think about it, there are a lot of these really great products that are very technical, that are very that there are a lot of specifications to. And you need to combine both your technical expertise as well as your foundational marketing knowledge to be able to effectively communicate what is the value of these very complex products. And so I was involved in a consulting project once where we had to figure out what was the value proposition and market positioning for a company that sells the heating and cooling systems that you might find in really large condo buildings or office buildings. And so technical selling is something that would utilize your technical knowledge as well as leverage marketing expertise when it comes to presenting the overall value of the product. Another area that is more technical, but still very much marketing, deals with the supply chain. And lately in the news, we've been hearing a lot about Amazon supply chain. We've been hearing a lot about Peloton supply chain and the vaccine supply chain. So this is something that's very much now in our minds as business people. And these roles are highly quantitative. They're really great roles. but they're not ones that students tend to think about as much. So in addition to what I have here, there are a number of other roles that also utilize marketing in some way. So if we think about brand and product management roles, we might be wondering, what are some of the skills that we might need, or some of the skill sets we might need to be effective in these roles? And typically when we think about brand and product management roles, you want to have very strong organizational skills. You want to have strong analytical skills. You want to have strong project management skills. And importantly, you want to have a strong fundamental understanding of marketing. And in addition to everything I just mentioned, something that's always appreciated is having a bit of creativity. So how can we think outside the box and think about things in new ways can help us come up with new and exciting solutions. So some of the typical roles you might see for these jobs are product manager, brand manager, marketing specialist, marketing coordinator. These would be some of the common roles that would be involved with these type of jobs. And importantly, you are having oversight or management of the marketing mix or a specific portion of the mix. Now, what are some examples of jobs that students might get in after graduation? So for example, you could join the CIBC credit card team as a market coordinator, or you could join the Amazon Canada team as a channel coordinator for one of their product categories, perhaps in the health category. Or maybe you join Air Canada as a social media specialist, and then you could be in charge of the day-to-day operations of their Instagram account and their Instagram strategy. So these could all be an example of jobs that you might get after graduation. The second type of roles we have deals with being an expert, a specialist in marketing, and helping out a number of different companies. Now, one of the cool things about these type of roles is that we have different roles and they utilize quite different skill sets. So if you're someone who's deeply creative, then you might note that there are creative roles which require more of a creative background. And if you enjoy thinking strategically about how to best communicate value to consumers, then there are actually a lot of roles that rely on having a really deep understanding of marketing, marketing strategy, and consumer behavior, and thinking about strategically how to best communicate with the customer. And then if you are the type of person that enjoys managing and organizing different things, there are a number of account management roles that really rely on the skills of project management, client management, organization, delegation, and so on. Now, the thing to remember is that all of these roles and all the people that work within these roles work in a deeply collaborative process, both within the agency. So the account managers, the strategists, and the creative specialists would all be working quite deeply hand in hand, but also with the clients themselves. So there is also a lot of communication that happens with the agency and the client. So these are deeply collaborative roles. Now, the third type of role is all about helping businesses develop a deep understanding of their customer, and then using these insights to inform the business and inform marketing strategy. And so these roles are an important part of marketing, and they can be quite different. And typically what you'll find is that individuals, they tend to lean more towards either the quantitative roles or the qualitative roles. And so quantitative roles might rely on your knowledge of statistics, econometrics, research methods, and mathematics. And you might be familiar with the terms big data and machine learning, and this could fall under more quantitative roles. But we also have some of the more traditional market research activities, such as surveys, A/B tests, as well as some of the newer initiatives, such as doing experiments or randomized control trials within the marketplace itself. And these are very exciting things that we've seen happen a fair bit in recent years. So the questions we might be answering with quantitative data might be either descriptive, so we're trying to understand how does the world around us look, or it can help us to answer causality. So for example, we might find in our research that using humor or comedy in our advertising actually results in an increase in purchase behavior. So that is an example of quantitative research. Now, the other type of research we tend to see are more qualitative research or qualitative roles. And here we're going to be using actually a different skill set. So with a qualitative role, what we're trying to do is we're trying to appreciate the richness of the data. And we'll use skill sets that's based more on inductive reasoning. And so you might, as you're trying to build this skill set, in addition to your marketing courses, you might take courses in sociology and anthropology. And a lot of the research in qualitative roles are more exploratory in nature. What we're trying to do is we're trying to learn more about a phenomenon, and perhaps we don't yet have any formal hypotheses that we're trying to test. So if you think of things like focus groups, interviews, observation, projective techniques, these would all be examples of qualitative research. And so in addition to having the expertise in doing research, some other skills we might want to cultivate would also be client management and project management skills as well. Because typically when you're doing research, you're not just working on one project, but you might be handling multiple projects at the same time. So I wanted to talk a bit about my own experience. And so in my experience, what I've tended to do work in is in that last category, the market and consumer research roles. So in my previous job, I was a management consultant that would use consumer behavior to help answer marketing questions. And I've worked with teams all across North America on some really cool and interesting challenges. So for instance, I've worked with the global branding team for one of the two largest beverage companies in the world. I've worked with the executive team, so namely the chief marketing officer and the chief financial officer for one of the leading Canadian retail companies. I've worked directly with the CEO of a very popular Canadian hospitality chain, and I've done a lot of work with the market research departments at most of the big five banks. So I've been able to work with a wide variety of people at different levels of seniority on some of their most pressing marketing challenges. And I actually wanted to share one specific challenge that I've actually worked on in my career. And so one of the things I did was I helped a national hospitality chain, so one of the leading hospitality chains in Canada. And the challenge was they had a menu, but their menu was quite dry. So it really just presented all the different options that they sell, but it wasn't really leveraging anything that we know from consumer behavior or from judgment and decision-making. And so the question we asked was, how can we leverage all of the latest knowledge from consumer behavior and from judgment and decision-making from marketing to create a more appealing menu? And so this was a project that went through several steps. And the first step was I first interviewed all of the senior staff, starting with the CEO to all of his direct reports. I wanted to get a good lay of the land of what is going on in the company and what was some of the motivation for the initial menu they created. Then I was able to do something very cool in marketing called mystery shopping. And so mystery shopping is when you go into the place of business of a company and the employees don't know that you're actually evaluating and analyzing what is going on. So I did some mystery shopping and I went to several locations and I got to do the very fun thing of ordering just about everything on the menu. And so I had a very fun afternoon where I was basically just eating a lot of very delicious food. And that was part of my project. After that, I then did a very deep dive of the marketing literature for any insights that applies to their business and the way that they created their menu. So I took everything that I learned from the interviews of senior staff, from my mystery shopping experience, as well as my own research. And using all that, I presented all my findings to the executive team. And this was a personal favorite project of mine because this hospitality chain has locations all across Canada. And they actually implemented new menus last year that was a direct result of my work with them. And so whenever I see one of my menus in the wild, so to speak, it does tend to fill me with an enormous sense of pride. So overall, I would say that there's a pretty wide variety in the different types of roles in marketing. And whether you are an analytical person or you're a creative person or somewhere in between, there's likely a role that would be a nice fit for you. So the best thing you can do is to really explore a bit more of this exciting world and see it for yourself. And I'll pass it back to you, Dr. Ray.
Thank you, Chris. That was wonderful. I really liked how well and how concisely you put this huge domain of marketing opportunities in your 15 minutes of talk. That was fantastic. Very nice. Of course, there are formal marketing roles, and as well as there are informal roles where one's marketing acumen is brought to bear. So I'm thinking of an ex-student of mine who started his career as a finance analysis, as a financial specialist or analyst in a bank. And then he found professional success as a channel manager at the bank. So that was a very marketing job. And then I'm also thinking of another student who joined the pharma industry essentially as an analyst, but again, later found professional success as a business development manager and account development manager, where her account was the government sector. So again, that's a very marketing job, and none of them really started out as a marketer, but they were trained in the marketing jobs. But, as I think about this, as we learn in marketing, it's also very important to have fun in the process of learning. And that's what we try to do in our marketing classes. And to talk about what we do, even outside of the classroom, we have our wonderful students, Leila and Naushin. And I'm going to hand it over to them to talk about what they do in terms of extracurriculars and what other opportunities you might be looking forward to. Leila and Naushin, over to you.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. Let me just share my screen. All right, there we go.
Awesome. So good morning, everyone. We're so happy that you guys are here viewing this. Starting off, we will be talking about our student-run club, which is the Group Marketing Association. This is among one of the clubs at DeGroote. So my name is Naushin. I'm currently in my fourth year and I'm focused in marketing. I'm a commerce student. So this past year in the DMA, I was the multimedia director. So I was in charge of creating all the graphics for our social media, kind of handling social media interactions, setting all that up. So I'm really excited to announce that this year I will, in the upcoming year, I will be a co-president, and I'm really excited to see where the year goes.
Yeah, and my name is Leila. I am currently finishing up my third year in commerce, specializing in marketing as well. My previous experiences within marketing include my marketing internship at King, the company that made Candy Crush, as well as my upcoming internship as a creative strategist at Teads, which is the leading company in in-text advertising. And this past year, I was a social media director for the DMA. And as Naushin mentioned already, we are next year's co-presidents and really excited about the next year. And we hope to see you all there as members next year. So our mission statement is to empower our members and bridge the gap between student ambition and opportunity by providing students with multiple opportunities for professional development, skill building, and networking. We intend to create a really positive community within DeGroote to foster stronger and new relationship among peers and provide valuable learning experiences. We aspire to create an inclusive and uplifting environment where members and students feel inspired and appreciated. And we strive to embody these core values by empowering, educating, and exploring.
Awesome. Thanks, Leila. So just to dive into a little bit about what exactly we do at the DMA. So we are a community of students with similar interests. Whether you have a little bit of interest in marketing or you already have a lot of experience and you want to help out the team, it's just for everyone. We like to have a fun social aspect to it as well. So we have several social events throughout the year too. And the main thing that we want to provide for students is experiential learning value. So outside of the class and the theories that you learn, we want to help you connect with professional marketing individuals out there. So that's why we host several different like workshops and case competitions, which Leila will be going into detail for in the next slide. And so we have like all different types of events like that. And also this upcoming year, we are trying to introduce a mentorship program. So this will help lower year students connect with upper year students who have experience with marketing internships. So they can ask questions about that, or it can just be school related, life related. Pretty much, we just want to create a close knit community where you feel comfortable to come to us with questions and really learn from the upper years as well. With the past year and everything being online and just COVID affecting everyone, it was really tough in general. And I think like we all know that. So that's why we realized that it's super important to have a more supportive online community as well. That's why we have our different social media platforms such as Facebook, Instagram, and we will be branching off into other platforms as well. And on those platforms, we want to be able to allow the community to connect better. So we're encouraging you all to reach out to us always, whether you have questions or you just want to talk about something. So we're there. And lastly, I wrote that the possibilities are endless. Once again, we want to create value for the community. So whatever you guys are interested in, what you want to learn about, you guys can also reach out to us and we'll look into ways to incorporate new different events that address those inquiries. And we can always learn from each other and have exciting new events. And Leila will go into the events we've had.
Wonderful, thank you. So the DMA has hosted a variety of case competitions, which are intended to immerse our members into real life marketing problems. So for the past 3 years, we have collaborated, for example, with Maple Leaf Sports Entertainment to organize a sports marketing related case competition where students can work together for a chance to make it to their national case competition. And also in the past, we've partnered with Microsoft to host a case competition regarding the importance of establishing effective brand awareness for the Microsoft team on university campuses. So these case competitions are intended to provide you the opportunity to use your critical thinking and time management skills, work through a marketing case together, and present to a panel of judges. So very hands-on experience. We have also hosted a variety of workshops in the past with professionals and organizations from the marketing realm to enhance members' skill set outside of the classroom. So we've hosted workshops relating to marketing analytics, digital marketing, professional development, and much more. And yearly, we also host Corporate Crawl, which is one of our favorite events. It's a very unique opportunity to visit a corporate office for an all-exclusive learning experience about their workplace. So the event consists of key speakers, executive panels, and a networking session. And as shown, last year's was with Twitter, which was very exciting. So this year, we partnered with Loblaws for Corporate Crawl. We hosted several panels, including one with Spotify, where members were able to learn about their consumer insights and what it takes to run the end of year Spotify Wrapped campaign. And coming up, we have several exciting events that we encourage you to check out. We have a sports industry conference, which we partnered with the McMaster Sports Business Association. It's this March 23rd. And come early April, we will also be hosting a panel with Activision Blizzard and King with professionals from Candy Crush, Call of Duty, and more. We hope to see you there. It's a very exciting event. All right, so thank you for tuning in today to learn more about marketing as an area of focus and for taking the time to learn more about us, the DMA. If you have any questions for any of the speakers today, we will be taking them after this, I believe. But please connect with us on Instagram and Facebook. And if you have any questions after the presentation, please feel free to DM us or email us. All our information is right here.
Yeah, thank you everyone for tuning in. We're so excited to connect with you all. And yeah, just like Leila mentioned, all of our socials are on the slide. And then, we're looking forward to interact with you all.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Leila and Naushin, a wonderful job. You really talked about what our students can really look forward to through your different activities. Let me take a couple of moments, a couple of seconds to introduce Professor Mandeep Malik to all the attendees. Professor Malik is in marketing. He's a senior professor in marketing. And of course, he's a great person to have with us as we go on to the question and answer session. Professor Malik has deep experience and insight into student engagement, not just in the classroom, but also outside of the classroom. And so we are open for any questions at this point. So let's go, Victoria.
So if anyone has any other questions, put them in the Q&A or into the chat. I've gotten a few that have come in. One question I've gotten, I got it twice. What would be a good minor to do with marketing if marketing was your area of focus? Anything that you'd suggest?
Chris?
Yeah, that's a wonderful question. So I really think it depends on your interests. So as you probably noted from some of my slides, marketing careers can be quite varied. And so you really want to pursue your interests. So for example, if you're more quantitative oriented, then the minor in economics or minor in mathematics or statistics could all be really good options. If you're someone that really craves those insights about how do people think, feel, and behave, then something that's quite common is perhaps a minor in psychology. And actually, that's what I did, was I actually got a minor in psychology. So that could be a nice avenue.
I actually get that question a lot from applicants, always specifically, what should they do if they want marketing? And so that's helpful for me now to take back as well. Another question I've had is there a certification that you can get in marketing, like you get your CPA for accounting?
Mandeep, would you like to briefly speak to this?
Sure. There is currently no certification required to come into marketing careers. People do, however, now pursue certifications depending on their area of interest, like Chris was talking about. So students might go take a certification through Google, Facebook, and become specialists on the digital side. They could also take certification through the Canadian Professional Sales Association and pursue a career in business development and selling. But per se, there are no roadblocks to entering this domain. That's why we find people from, you know, the business school who have an advantage, but there are also students who come through our social sciences program, our health sciences program, and our engineering management program who end up finding careers in marketing.
Perfect. The next question I have is, what industries can a marketing graduate work in?
Okay, I can take a stab at that. And I think as I mentioned in my early presentation, that marketing skills are transferable across a wide variety of contexts. So I cannot really think of a particular industry where your marketing skills will not be useful. So there are a variety of jobs, both in business to consumer industries to business, from low tech to high tech, from FMCG to consumer durables. So the world is your oyster, really, once you become a expert in marketing.
Perfect. The next question, so we would start our minor by first year. I can answer that one. So you can start taking the courses for your minor in your first year with your elective space. You could also talk to an advisor about how to plan your year and how to make sure you're getting those courses in, just so you have time. Good, yes, perfect answer. Thank you. The next question was a little bit more about expanding on the cases that they have in third year. Do the students have to find their own case or companies to work with, or do you have prepared cases for them?
Mandeep, I want you to speak to this given our experiences. Yeah.
So I'm glad this question came up. The first thing you have to keep in mind is that 3MC3 Applied Marketing Management, which is a required course for all students, whether you're pursuing marketing, accounting, finance, or HR, is the only fully case-based course you will take during your years at DeGroote. So in that sense, it's extraordinary. Now, within the course, you have two experiences. One is there are cases that are discussed in class, and those cases are selected by instructors, and they're part of your courseware pack. And you don't have to worry about finding those cases. Besides those cases, you do work with a small business to do a marketing audit and write a marketing plan. Leila's working on right now with a local business called AI Endurance. Am I right, Leila? And that's an app, artificial intelligence app to train triathletes. Extraordinary. For that, we do help you find businesses. However, depending on your own interests, your industry interests or personal passions, we are quite open to you bringing a business on board. So in Leila's case, luckily we had a local business that had approached us and we connected them with her team. But there are so many other student groups who have brought on their own projects and they have been approved by instructors. Lots of flexibility there.
That's great. Thank you. The next question is, how's the position for marketing in the consulting industry? I heard if you want to become a business consultant, it's more for tech, finance, accounting.
Okay. So I will respond to that briefly and then I'll hand it over to Chris and even I'll let Mandeep also come in later because this is a very interesting, important, and a question that I get asked a lot of times. So let me talk about my own experience. I've done a fair bit of consulting as a marketer for companies going from very small startups all the way to Fortune 500 firms. So that's so your expertise in marketing is not going to be a hindrance to it. Now, the people follow different paths to consulting. And so I'm going to now hand it over to Chris to talk about his experiences as a consultant. So it comes in very well. Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, I would say that the field of consulting and marketing is a very healthy field. There are plenty of positions there. And what I've found is that there are different paths, as Dr. has mentioned, to getting into consulting. So one of the most common paths that students think about is maybe taking that general management consulting route. So you think of some of the bigger consulting firms and thinking of traditionally going there, but there's also a pathway and those general management consulting firms, they do tackle marketing questions. They do tackle marketing challenges. And so when you specialize in these firms, you might specialize in areas that deal more with marketing in general. Now, the other way you can get involved with marketing and consulting is you can work for firms that specifically target marketing challenges. So you can join a firm that advertises or positions itself as a marketing consulting firm. There are also a lot of consulting firms that deal with specific marketing issues. So one of the more popular areas of marketing consulting in recent years has been branding. So there's a lot of these brand consulting firms that are helping companies to optimize their brand image. So thinking about what are some of the brand associations that consumers have and how can we reposition ourselves to have more success in the marketplace. And that's another area that we've been seeing additional consulting happening in. So there's a lot of different areas to consult in. It's really a matter of what's your personal interest.
Mandy?
Yeah, I mean, we are seeing two sort of consulting pathways emerge. You find firms like Accenture, which are now in technology consulting with a special focus. And now we are seeing, you know, the big four accounting firms, KPMG, Deloitte, PwC, Ernst & Young, come back into finance and accounting consulting. But when you look at the big consulting houses, whether it's, you know, BCG or Bain or McKinsey, they're all working in the space of strategy, which checks off all the boxes. And what typically happens that you must consider is they have multidisciplinary teams working on projects. So there will be somebody who has a background in marketing and strategy. There might be someone who's more finance. There might be someone who's more operations. And these multidisciplinary teams will tackle projects that are fairly large scale. I have a past student who's right now working with Government of Ontario on finding solutions to bringing vaccinations in an organized way into play in the market. And he does work with Boston Consulting Group. So a strategy consulting right now working on operationalizing vaccines for the COVID pandemic.
That's great answers. I get this question a lot from applicants. So now I can just send them to this video and tell them to go watch this, the last 3 or 4 minutes. So we have time for a final question. I think it's a good question to end with. And the question is, how can I get involved and start getting experience in marketing from my first year? So this might be a good question for our students to start with.
Yeah. So Leila, Naushin, do you want to?
Yeah. So like we said, we have a lot of workshops and case competitions that you can attend as a member of the DMA. They provide a lot of hands-on experiences. So for example, we're actually planning to have a marketing consultant from Deloitte come in and prepare a hands-on case and walk you through how they would go about solving that. So experiences like that, like I said, the case competitions are really, really great hands-on where you can create your own marketing solutions and present to a judges. So they help you a lot in developing your professional skills. And Naushin, if you want to add on anything to that.
Yeah. And aside from DMA as well, if you want to get involved, there are so many different types of marketing related clubs and programs that you can join at McMaster, such as Top Ed Exec, Mars Apprentice Program, and then several other clubs as well. They have their marketing position, so you can apply to be an executive member and become like the marketing person for their club. And yeah, there's just so many different opportunities. I know everything is just always posted through the Instagram platforms. So just stay tuned on that. Follow like every Mac DeGroote club and any marketing club, they're all on there and they'll usually update you with any way that you can join. So there's so many different options.
That's perfect. So after this webinar, feel free to reach out to us, feel free to reach out to the clubs. You can reach out to us on Discord if you have any other questions. Definitely reach out to DMA. They can answer a lot of your questions. I see a final question. Where can I find the recording of this webinar and others? They're all gonna be posted on YouTube. So still have to close caption them, but once that's all ready, we'll post them all on YouTube so you can refer back to them. So if you have that question again about how to get into marketing consulting, you can go back and check. So those should be posted in the next week or two. But now we're done for today. But if you have any other questions about marketing, please feel free to email us at BuzzCon, reach out to DMA, or put it into Discord. Thank you for attending. Thank you again to our panelists, to our faculty and staff. I hope everyone has a good day. Thank you.
Thank you.